Good afternoon, everyone, and thank you for joining our WNCT Now late afternoon news update. I'm Kelsey O'Donnell here in the digital studio with some of today's top news headlines in between our newscast. We're continuing to monitor the latest developments with the coronavirus across the state of North Carolina and more specifically about the vaccine distribution process. This afternoon, Governor Roy Cooper and North Carolina Health and Human Services Secretary Dr. Mandy Cohen announced an accelerated timeline for moving groups 4 and 5 up for vaccine eligibility. The remainder of groups 4 is eligible on March 31st. That includes essential workers and people living in other congregated settings, such as dorms. Additionally, all North Carolina adults are now eligible to be vaccinated beginning on April 7th. Capitol reporter Michael Hyland will have more details regarding the vaccination process coming up tonight at 5 and 6 on WNCT. Carolina East Medical Center welcomes back its hospital volunteers after temporarily shutting down the program. Hospital officials say the program was suspended last March due to COVID restrictions. Now, volunteers can go back to help out healthcare workers. Today was their first day back, and the center rolled out the red carpet for this special moment. The hospital says they have about 400 volunteers in the program, and they are all fully vaccinated. More money is being sent to millions of Americans, but some people are having problems getting those funds. 20 million checks will be sent by direct deposit. 17 more will be sent through the Postal Service. Because the U.S. mail system continues to experience delays, those payments could take time to get to people. The best way to track your stimulus check is to use the Postal Service's informed delivery, which will help track it right to your mailbox. The IRS says some delays are due to married people whose past funds were withheld over spouses' past due debts. The agency is also asking for patience because they are processing the backlog from the 2019 tax season, as well as this year's tax return. Senators are pushing for an extension of the Paycheck Protection Program. The American Rescue Plan included additional cash for the Paycheck Protection Program, but not an extension of the program itself. The program is set to expire in 1 week and still has $128 billion up for grabs. As always, you can find the latest information on our website at WNCT.com. Still ahead on WNCT Now updates these details regarding the search efforts on the Neuse River in Goldsboro. We'll have the details in just a bit.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good evening.
You're watching
live coverage of a news conference.
Live to breaking news.
We're live outside.
Join us live
in Kinston.
In Jacksonville.
In New Bern.
Now in Greenville.
Dangerous condition.
We don't dare drop our guard.
Rip currents can be really hard to spot.
The Washington waterfront.
Chair pieces and cable lines.
Walking you through the story.
Working day in and day out.
This election.
Unprecedented.
I did speak to the Board of Elections director.
We are there with you.
We're on your side.
Nine on your side.
Weekdays starting at 5.
Finally, the wait is over. Storm Team 9 is here. Our experienced team is keeping you informed and keeping you safe. Depend on Storm Team 9.
Welcome back in, everyone. If you're just now joining, I'm Kelsey O'Donnell here in the digital studio with some of today's top news headlines in between our newscasts. Like we mentioned before the break, we are monitoring a developing story this afternoon. A search is continued for a man and his 5-year-old son that went missing on the Neuse River in Goldsboro. The Wayne County Sheriff's Office says the child fell into the water and his father jumped in to the water to try to save him on Wednesday. Boats went into the water just after 8 o'clock this morning and have been there ever since in an effort to locate the two. The Wayne County Sheriff's Aviation Unit was also flying over the scene looking for the man and his son. Witnesses tell investigators they saw the boy fall into the river and his father jumped in to save them, but they never came back up. The man's other 7-year-old son was also there at the time. Now, first responders are doing a larger search of the area. We will continue to monitor this story and bring you the latest developments on air and online at WNCT.com. A little closer to home in Greenville, city leaders will be breaking ground today on the new Wildwood Adventure Park. The first phase of the groundbreaking ceremony will be held at 5:30. The ceremony is an invitation-only event, and members of the media are invited to attend. However, it will also be broadcasted live from the public to the public on the city's Facebook page. Now, on your side's Ford Sanders will have more on his live report coming up tonight at 5 and 6 right here on WNCT. Turning now to weather, our Storm Team 9 meteorologist Alex Wasilenko joins us from the studio with a Thursday weather update. Alex?
Happy Little Friday, everybody. I'm your Storm Team 9 meteorologist, Alex Wasilenko, reporting from the WNCT studios in the Storm Team 9 Weather Center. Today, we're discussing some periods of sunshine, blustery south winds, and warming temperatures. Those temperatures will warm into the upper 70s to low 80s today under some partly cloudy skies and those peaks of sunshine. But back to the west, it is a mess in the deep south. From Alabama to Mississippi and even southern Tennessee, likely going to experience a very high severe weather risk today, a 5 out of 5 on the severe weather scale. So if you have friends or family in Alabama, Mississippi, even northern Georgia to southern Tennessee, make sure they're staying weather aware. That system will make a run into the Carolinas as we go through late tonight into early Friday morning as the clock has stopped at midnight. It's looking like some strong to severe storms and maybe even isolated tornadoes lining up across the western portion of the state and just east of the North Carolina mountains. But watch as that system goes up and over the North Carolina mountains and heads towards eastern North Carolina. It's going to lose a lot of steam. But notice, too, there's still a lot of lift in the atmosphere via those southerly winds. And temperatures will be warm during the day Friday, if not hot, in the middle to upper 80s for some inland. Wouldn't be surprised to see some folks flirt with a 90-degree mark if there's enough sunshine. But with that being said, the warm air, the peaks of sunshine, and those southerly winds are severe weather ingredients, so it would be entirely possible to see one of those showers that pops up in the morning through the early afternoon turn into a strong to severe storm. It isn't until the evening and overnight on Friday that that cold front begins to ship out to sea, clearing out those skies late and giving way to slightly more comfortable conditions moving forward. The severe weather risk for Friday here in eastern North Carolina still exists. It is a 1 out of 5 on the severe weather scale, not 0. So that's why you need to remain weather aware by downloading that free Storm Team 9 weather app. We continue to gather all the details of that potential for severe weather tomorrow, but it is more and more likely looking like it's not going to materialize other than just an isolated strong to severe storm or stray spin-up. It's important to note that on Friday, not everybody's going to see a storm, a shower, or tornado chance. Those chances for showers and storms and severe weather in general, very low, but check out those temperatures. They're going to be very high in the mid-80s, inland upper 70s by Saturday with a plethora of sunshine and also some drier weather. But by Sunday, the next disturbance arrives with some scattered showers and storms for inland and coastal communities. Next week, we cool back down to near seasonable averages in the lower to middle 60s under partly sunny skies for both Monday and Tuesday. Make it a happy rest of your Little Friday, everybody. I'm your Storm Team 9 meteorologist, Alex Wasilenko.
Thank you, Alex. To find the latest weather update as well as any further details regarding any of these headlines listed today, head over to our website at WNCT.com. This will do it for our WNCT Now late afternoon news update. Thanks so much for tuning in.